This video introduces you to the basics of creating ice particle simulations. You'll see how easy it is to use ice to create particle simulations, first by using a preset, then by creating an effect from scratch. Softimage has several presets on the ice toolbar that you can use to learn about ice particles. To start, select an object that will be the particle emitter. We'll use this polygon mesh disk that's constrained to this flower. We'll create some particles using the basic fire preset. You can change the settings in this preset's property page, such as the color, purlin noise, and particle size. You can also see what's going on inside the ice tree that got created. Press Alt plus 9 to open the ice tree view. Ice trees contain nodes that either get data from the scene or modify and process data. Compounds are a type of node that contain multiple nodes, like the basic fire compound here. You can modify a compound by connecting nodes to its ports. You can find all nodes in the preset manager on the left. We'll use this node to add some turbulence to the particle's direction. The ice particle presets also include shaders. Press the 7 key to open the render tree view to see the shaders. Press the Q key and draw a render region around the particles. Now let's delete the firepoint cloud and make our own particle effect from scratch. Select the disk again as the particle emitter. An emitter can be one or more objects of almost any type of geometry. An easy way to create and emit particles is to choose the basic emission command. Three things happen when you choose this command. A point cloud object is created. Particles are emitted from the disk. And a simulated ice tree is created for the point cloud. This ice tree is what's driving the particle simulation on this point cloud. If you go back to the first frame, you see that particles aren't actually emitted until the second frame of the simulation. That's because the first frame sets the particle simulation's initial state, which we'll talk about later. Now, let's get a closer look at what's going on inside the ice tree. The nodes you see in this tree are the basic nodes that are normally required for any particle simulation. The ice tree node is the main node in any ice tree, sort of like Grand Central Station for all nodes that are plugged into it. At each frame, the ice tree node processes all the nodes that are connected to its ports, going from the top to the bottom. Because we're creating a particle simulation, the ice tree node is also simulated. This means that the ice tree operator is in the simulation region of the point cloud's construction stack. And remember that initial state? It's the result of the data from any operators that are plugged in below the simulation region. It gets set on the first frame that the simulation is active. The simulation root node is also a central station, but is used only for simulated particle effects. The port names help you figure out where certain nodes should be plugged in when you're building an ice tree. If you want to use many of the particle commands on the ice toolbar, you need to have the simulation root node connected in the point cloud's ice tree. The emit from geometry node is responsible for creating and emitting the particles. At every frame, it adds points and sets their attributes such as size, color, velocity, mass, shape, and so on. We'll take a closer look at these in the next video. An emit node is always plugged into the emitter port at the top of the simulation root node. This is because you need to emit the particles before anything can happen to them. This getData node represents the emitter object. It simply gets the geometry data from that object so that it can be used in the ice tree. The Simulate Particles node updates the position and velocity of each particle at each frame based on its mass, position, and velocity from the previous frame. Updating each frame based on the previous frame is what makes the particles simulated. If you unplug the Simulate Particles node, you can see that the particles still get emitted, but their position and velocity aren't updated, so they don't move. This node is plugged in below the emitter, force, and execute ports. This is because it needs to take information from the nodes plugged into those ports in order to calculate the particles' movement at each frame. Now, let's start changing the general movement of the particles. By default, particles have a speed at emission time, but you can change their speed and direction after emission by using different forces. Let's add some gravity to see how that affects the particles. Choosing any command from the Force menu adds that Forces node to the ice tree and plugs it into the Add Forces node. The Add Forces node is a hub into which you need to plug all force nodes. You can plug the forces in any order into this node. They're all simply added together. If you need to rearrange the nodes in the ice tree at any time, press Ctrl-R. You can also add forces using the compounds in the Forces group in the Preset Manager. For a simple directional force, you can even use the Add Forces node on its own. We'll do that here to create the effect of a wind. Double-click on a node to open its property page. Let's first add a force in the X and Y directions to see how that looks. Now, let's add some turbulence to create noise on the force so that there is some variation in the particle movement and direction. First, let's set the base value for the axes we want to use, then set the variance on each of the axes. The turbulent scale sets the magnitude of the effect. We'll animate the turbulence and set its speed so that there is even more variation. Now we have some lovely pollen being spewed out by our flower. In the next video, you'll see how to adjust the particle attributes and build up the ice tree.